Hello everyone, in this video we will cover a triangle question and apply 6 different solutions. First of all, let's introduce our question. This length is given 10 units and here is given 15 units. Here is alpha and this angle is given 2 alpha and x is asked. Okay, let's start with the first method. First of all, if you extend corner A by x units, then let's connect these two corners. Let's call here point K. If you notice that this triangle is an isosceles triangle. So if it is 2 alpha, that means these are must be equal alpha. Right? Okay. Then if you focus on this triangle, let's call here theta. The angles of yellow triangle are alpha, 2 alpha, and theta, right? If you focus on the biggest triangle, likewise, the angles of the biggest triangles are alpha, 2 alpha, and theta. That means triangle BAC and triangle BCK are similar. If you start the calculation with this triangle, 15, which is opposite of the 2 alpha, over 10 plus x, which is opposite of the 2 alpha, must be equal 10, which is opposite of the alpha, over 15, which is opposite of the alpha, right? Okay, if you simplify the expression, therefore, 4 to 5 equal 20 plus 2x, that means 2x equal 25, so x is going to be 12.5 units. Okay. This was the first method. Now, we will calculate second method. To make the calculation easier, let's call these two lengths 2x. Notice that there's an angle bisector line here, so let's call here y. According to angle bisector theorem, y over 2x must be equal 15 over 10, right? If you simplify the expression, that means y equal 3x. Let's write here y equal 3x. So the square of the angle bisector's length is equal to 2x whole squared equal 15 times 3x minus 10 times 2x. Right? 4x squared equal 45x minus 20x. So 4x squared equals 25x. That means 4x equal 25. So 2x equal 12.5 units. Okay. Now we will calculate the value of x using third methods. This time, if we extend corner A by 10 units, after that, if we connect these two corners, let's call here point T, if here is 2 alpha, that means these angles must be equal alpha. Then, if we focus on the biggest triangle, notice that the biggest triangle has become an isosceles triangle, so if it is 15, that means this length is also 15 units. Therefore, triangle TAB, and let's write here, triangle TAB and triangle CTB are similar. So if it is double line, Notice that these two angles are equal. That means the third angle must be equal double line. If you start the calculation with this triangle, 10, which is opposite of the alpha, over 15, which is opposite of the alpha, must be equal 15, which is opposite of the double line, over 10 plus x, which is opposite of the double line. Let's look for the expression. Therefore, 20 plus 2x equal 45. That means 2x equal 25. So x is going to be 12.5 units. Or you can apply C-Tewer theorem. Right? Let's call third method. According to C-Tewer theorem, square of this length, 10 squared, must be equal 15 squared times x plus 15 squared times 10 over sum of these two parts, 10 plus x minus 10x. Therefore, if you move these terms left hand side of the equation, 100 plus 10x times 10 plus x equal 225x plus 2250. If you distribute 1000 plus 100x plus 100x plus 10x squared equal 225x plus 2250. Therefore, 10x squared minus 25x minus 1250 equal 0. Right? Therefore, if you divide both sides of the equation by 5, we get 2x squared minus 5x minus 250 equals 0. 2x squared equals 2x times x, and minus 250 equals minus 25 times 10. Therefore, 2x equals 25. That means x is going to be 12.5 units. Now also, let's calculate value of x using fifth methods. First of all, let's draw an angle bisector line. Notice that two interior angles equals one exterior angles, so here must be equal to alpha. Let's call here theta. Let's call here point M. If you notice that this triangle and this triangle have same angles, that means triangle BAM and triangle BCA are similar. Right? Let's call here Y. That means here must be equal 15 minus Y. This triangle is an isosceles triangle, so this length is also 15 minus y. If we apply similarity theorem, y, which is opposite of the alpha, over 10, which is opposite of the alpha, equal 10, which is opposite of the 2 alpha, over 15, which is opposite of the 2 alpha, must be equal 15 minus y, which is opposite to theta, over x, which is opposite of the theta. Okay. If we use left hand side of the equation, what's that? 10 over 15 equal 2 over 3. So 3y equal 20, that means y is going to be 20 over 3. Now also, if you use right-hand side of the equation, 2x equal 45 minus 3y, so 2x equal 45 minus 3 times, we know that y equals 20 over 3, these are again, so 2x equal 25, that means x equal 12.5 units. Now also, let's calculate value of x using 6 methods. Okay. For this triangle, if we apply sine rule, 10 over sine alpha must be equal 15 over sine 2 alpha. Therefore, if we simplify the expression, 2 times sine 2 alpha equal 3 times sine alpha, right? You know that sine 2 alpha equals 2 times sine alpha times cosine alpha equal 3 times sine alpha. So if you simplify the expression, these are again, therefore cosine alpha equal 3 over 4. We know that angle alpha is here, right? So for this triangle, if we apply cosine rule, let's put it here. So according to cosine rule, 10 squared equal 15 squared plus x squared minus 2 times 15 times x times cosine alpha. Therefore, 100 equal 225 plus x squared minus 2 times 15 times x times, we know that cosine alpha equal 3 over 4. Let's simplify. And let's clear here. 3 over 2, right? So if you multiply by 2 both sides of the equations, 200 equal 450 plus 2x squared minus 45x. So if you organize the equation, 2x squared minus 45x plus 250 equals 0. You know that 2x squared equals 2x times x, and 250 equals minus 25 times minus 10. Therefore, 2x minus 25 times x minus 10 equals 0. Therefore, x equals 10, but it's impossible. Why? Not that if x is 10, this triangle becomes an isosceles triangle. So here must be equal alpha. That means 2 alpha must be equal 180 degrees, so 2 alpha equals 90 degrees. That means angle BAC must be equal 90 degrees, so hypotenuse must be equal 10 root 2, right? But notice that hypotenuse is 50 units. So this value cancels out. Therefore, 2x equals 25. That means x is going to be 12.5 units. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.